This video is rated Bakugo with a hint of Mineta.
That means there's cussing and Mineta thoughts. Okay.
Make sure to go support the author. The link to the fanfiction is in the description below. And I hope you're having a good day, night, or whenever you're watching this. I normally say that at the end of the video, but like, why not now? My cousin's in the room. Okay, Totoroni, it's your time to shine. Be your Totoroni self. There she is again. Todoroki thought as he patrolled his usual route. Every time he walked by this small shop, there is this woman who keeps making an odd face at him. It's so strange. And suspicious. Todoroki was starting to think she was planning something. He couldn't read her expression at all. Which isn't really saying much for him, but still. It was odd. There was always someone in the shop that would take the woman's eyes off of Todoroki after a while, and her expression would completely change to something pleasant and kind. He's used to receiving looks from people, especially women. Midoriya had informed him that women find him quite handsome and that his aloof personality makes them swoon. But this is not the same look that he's used to. There has been some activity lately where low-grade villains terrorize the shops in this area, and other villains offer their protection from those villains for payment. Someone has been spying for this group of villains, so they never do their activities when the heroes are on patrol. Todoroki is starting to suspect this woman that has been giving him this odd glare. But he has no evidence other than she looks at him funny. A scream brought Todoroki out of his thoughts. Someone was running down the street. A woman shouted that someone had stolen her purse. Never an uneventful day as a hero. You struggled to keep your eyes off the two-toned off-duty hero standing in the grocery store. He had been staring at the two packs of soba noodles in his hands for the past 5 minutes. Your roommate had yet again threatened to lock you out of the apartment if you didn't bring home soba noodles. Maybe if you go over nonchalantly and just grab the noodles, he won't notice you. He's so fucking hot! Your eyes are practically glued to his arms, memorizing every curve of his muscles exposed due to the short-sleeve shirt he was wearing. It's not fair! It was bad enough that he patrols by your store, distracting you. Now you have to worry about running into him at the grocery store? Though, seeing him in his civilian clothes wasn't bad. You get to see the muscles instead of having to imagine them from their movement underneath his hero costume. Someone cleared their throat and you blinked to see the hero, Shoto, looking at you with a raised eyebrow. You had been lost in thought. Your arm was still outstretched towards the soba noodles while staring at his bicep. Can I help you? No! You pulled your hand away like it had caught fire. Bye! You try to run away, face threatening to release the most painful blush you would ever had. But a hand grabs you and you are spun around to see the hero now hovering over you. You gulped. His eyes narrow at you. You are the girl from the shopping district. I have a few questions for you. Your mind is screaming internally so loudly that you don't notice the dark tone he spoke in. I've seen you staring at me suspiciously when I go on patrol. Are you working with the group of villains terrorizing the area? That startled you. Wait, what? He stepped closer to you, his beautiful two-colored eyes becoming more intense. I've noticed you stare at me with an odd expression. Why?
I do?
Do you make a face when you space out? Had you been making faces this whole time? Have you been making a face just now? As the hero's breath hit your face, your body went into panic mode. You had been lusting after him for so long that it couldn't decide if you should just get closer or run. Your brain decided to talk and try to clear the mix-up as you took a step back. I'm sorry. I swear I have nothing to do with the villains. I want them gone. They've broke my shop window so many times because I don't give them money. He followed you as you took another step.
Then why have you been staring at me?
Still panicking, your brain decides to do the worst thing possible. Tell the truth. Because I practically undress you with my eyes every time I see you. I can't help it. I keep checking you out. You are unbelievably hot. Like every time I see you, my mind becomes totally lost in every dirty sexual fantasy I can think of. You gasp, out of breath and shock at what had just come out of your mouth. Both of your hands come up and slap across your stupid mouth before it could go into any more detail. The hero blinked at you a few times, his expression nearly completely blank, but his eyes wide with surprise. He takes a few steps away from you, almost like he was trying to escape. Okay. He turned around and practically ran out of the aisle. My life is over. Someone kill me. Anyone. You squat down on the ground, screeching into your hands. What the fuck is wrong with you? Midoriya looked up from the couch as he heard the door shut. He was reading a magazine with an article about gravity in it.
Ah, Shoto-chan, did you get the new wasabi-flavored soba you wanted to try?
His eyes widened with concern when he saw Todoroki walk by, his face slightly flushed.
Are you okay? You look a little red.
Todoroki gave him a curt nod as he put the groceries down on the counter.
Yeah. A woman just told me she thinks of dirty sex fantasies when she sees me.
Oh, okay, what?! Midoriya almost ripped the magazine in half. For the next couple of days, you changed while Todoroki was on his patrol. You would stare at him till you noticed him looking and turned away as fast as possible, completely flushed from your face down to your neck. Todoroki found that this new development was actually pretty cute. Now that he knew what you were thinking, as awkward as it was, he found it endearing and he felt more at ease as he walked. One day, he made a bold decision. He wanted to see if he could fluster you even more.
What is it that Kaminari does when he flirts with women while on patrol or interviews? That.
He thought for a moment. As he came closer to your shop, he made sure not to look at you until the last possible moment. About to walk by, he turned to you, looked you straight in the eye with a small smile, and winked. Your face flushed faster than normal, eyes going wide, and he could tell that you took a deep breath. He couldn't help the chuckle that came out as he walked away with a little sprint in his step.
That felt strange. Did I do it correctly? It was fun though. I wonder what expression I'll get tomorrow.
Meanwhile, as the hero's back was turned, you had fallen to your knees behind the counter. Your heart was racing.
What the fuck? Did he just wink at me? And smile? How? What? Why? Oh my god, stop being so fucking hot! I can't even!
You squealed into your hands, completely unable to handle the smooth and subtle flirty wink that had possibly just been sent your way.
Are you okay?
A concerned customer looked down at you.
No, I'm dying!
The same villain group had begun hitting other districts, along with the one Todoroki patrols. Todoroki's agency decided that they wanted the heroes to patrol in pairs in civilian wear. Heroes from other agencies that weren't generally seen in that area had started to help out as well. Luckily for him, the person he was partnered up with was someone he knew very well.
It's so cool we finally get to work together, Todoroki!
Kirishima slung a heavy, muscular arm around Todoroki's shoulder. In order to be less recognizable, Kirishima was wearing his hair down.
Yes, it is nice to be with someone that I am familiar with in combat.
Todoroki adjusted his hat, keeping his hair tucked inside. Kirishima let out a deep belly laugh as they continued their patrol.
That too, but we haven't talked in a while. I know you and Midoriya are roommates still, but I haven't heard anything new about you.
Todoroki was half listening to Kirishima as he talked. He was more focused on trying to see if you were at your shop. He is curious to know if you'll recognize him in this disguise. Ah, there you were. Smiling at a customer as you handed them their purchase in a plastic bag. You seemed relaxed and cheery. Though, he'll admit that he liked your flustered expression much more.
Yo, Todoroki, bro, what you looking at? You got this really happy expression on your face.
Kirishima came into Todoroki's line of sight, cutting off his view of you. Todoroki looked around Kirishima to catch another glimpse of you, but someone else was working the counter outside now. You must have gone inside the shop. Todoroki sighed as he continued on with the patrol.
Kirishima?
Huh?
I heard you were in a relationship now.
Kirishima choked on air at Todoroki's straightforward statement.
How were you able to get to that point?
What do you mean? Kirishima was completely thrown off by Todoroki's choice of topic. He never thought he would ever be talking to the cool and collected Todoroki about romance.
I mean, how do you start? Were you friends first or strangers? How do you express interest in a romantic relationship?
Todoroki listed off his questions without an ounce of embarrassment as Kirishima slowly became as red as his hair. Kirishima nervously scratched the back of his head as he struggled to find the words to say.
Well, I'm not the best person to ask. I'm a disaster when it comes to this kind of stuff. I'm still surprised they even said yes with the way I acted. But I know you don't have to be friends first to be interested. Just be honest and straightforward. Ask them to dinner so you can get to know them better.
How? They were interrupted by people running and screaming. In front of the heroes were the exact villains they had been looking for. Three were trashing a convenience store while one was holding a woman down on the ground. Kirishima hardened his body, now getting ready to charge.
Looks like we'll have to continue this talk later.
He took off running and tackled the man holding the woman down. Todoroki rushed into the store and found two store clerks huddled together behind the counter. He gave them a quick nod as he turned towards the rest of the store. There didn't seem to be any other civilians. Once he had confirmed this, he quickly sent ice towards the low-grade villains and froze them in the midst of causing more destruction. It was quick and easy. The villains were more like organized thugs than villains. Todoroki escorted the clerk out and met with Kirishima.
Man, I barely even handcuffed one guy and you already took out three.
Todoroki only shrugged at him till he noticed someone behind him.
You.
You had been the woman that was being held down outside. The police came and collected the criminals. Apparently, you had tried to call for the pros before they caught you. Todoroki was half listening to the police officer as he watched an EMT check over you. Kirishima was standing with you, possibly praising you for how manly you were for fighting against the villains. Finally, you looked up, your eyes meeting his and your face instantly turned red.
Honest and straightforward, huh?
Todoroki smiled to himself as he walked towards you, ignoring the police officer that was still talking to him and anyone else that tried to get his attention. His eyes were completely focused on you. You were squirming in your seat as he stopped 2 feet away.
Since you like to stare at me a lot, I thought you would like to stare at me some more over dinner, perhaps tonight.
He paused to take out a piece of paper and write on it before handing it to you with a wink like before.
Let me know.
He walked away as you melt in your seat, clutching the note to your chest. Kirishima whistled.
Damn, now that was straightforward.
I think this is the most fun I've had recording a video. Oh my god, the amount of screaming and cussing. I fangirled multiple times because Todoroki was just being Todoroki, but like, well, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope you're having a nice day, night/afternoon. I got a TikTok if you guys want to follow me over there. I might post some bloopers or something on there. Or funny moments. I'm not sure yet. I'm not sure what I want to do with it. But it's called Fanfic Panda, so go check it out if you want to. Yeah. Okay. I hope you're good. I'm so bad at outros. Bye!